Racing in the Rain. Not everyone masters it. Some hate it. If you ever want to be a champion, you will have to master it.
It's gotta be against the law to look this damn good. Cause baby, I feel real good, and I wish y'all would.
Let's first talk riding technique. What is special about riding in the rain in the first place? An interesting aspect of racing in the rain is that you can brake almost as hard in a dry and a straight line. But you cannot trail brake as hard nor use as big lean angles. In amateur racing, you see many riders not realizing that you can brake that hard in a straight line in the wet. I use this to my advantage racing in the rain down in Southern California. While using the brakes properly in a straight line is important, professional races are won or lost on the throttle in the rain. Throttle control is really the primary riding skill that sets apart those good in the rain and those who are not. You have to be incredibly smooth on the throttle, finding the sweet spot where the tire is just about to go, accelerating as hard as possible. If you have never raced in the rain, it might be hard to understand how different the feel is from riding on a dry track. The time from when the tire starts letting go to full-on slide is minimal in the rain. You have milliseconds to react and correct your input, even if you are being super smooth on the throttle. So now we know some basic riding techniques when riding in the rain. What about the motorcycle? As usual, it all starts with the tires. So how do rain tires work? Well, if we were to use slicks in the wet, what would happen? First of all, hydroplane. Hydroplaning happens when water have nowhere to go from under the tire and the tire rides on top of it. This is solved by adding grooves to the tires, which channels the water away, allowing the tread to be in contact with the road. Okay, but say we would groove our own slicks, which I did for that race in Southern California. This mitigates hydroplaning, but we still have another big problem, temperature. All tires have what is called an optimal operating temperature. If you are kept within this optimal temperature range, they provide the most grip, which is why you generally have different tire pressures for different ambient and track temperatures when riding on a racetrack. When the tire is within its optimum temperature range, the rubber drapes over the asperities in the road. When it's too cold, it does not deform properly, or in other words, the tire is really hard and won't provide much grip, which is why going fast on cold tires is a bad idea. So I think you already figured out what the problem with grooved slicks is. Their compound is made for warm summer days with no rain in sight. Not only does the ambient and track temperatures tend to be low when it rains, the water effectively cools down the tires as well. So the compounds used for rain tires are usually softer than the softest slicks. Rains also have a lower optimum operating temperature. Not only is the compound different, the fact that there are grooves in the tire allows it to flex more, which enables it to build up temperature faster. What about the suspension? Well, the suspension settings should be softer, since the rider inputs will be smoother and more progressive. Another part of this is weight bias. I read an article from Box Repsol explaining that they shift the weight bias rearward when racing in the wet. It all makes sense, since less emphasis is put on grip on the front tire when entering corners, and smooth throttle control powering out of corners is key. For powering out of corners in MotoGP, the electronics play a big role, allowing to tune the engine's response to throttle input with a more progressive power delivery. Traction control is another key feature used in the rain, with custom maps for different wet conditions. In MotoGP, the engines can in fact get too cool when racing in the rain, because water splashes up from the front tire onto the radiator. So race engineers use tape to protect the radiator from water splashing up from the front tire. When it comes to the attire, visors can be treated so that water slides off easily, and a double visor system can be used to mitigate fogging. Then of course there are waterproof suits and protective layers to keep the riders warm and also not making the suit heavy from absorbing water. Remember to subscribe to my channel if you want to see more content like this. There is always something new to learn.
It's gotta be against the law to look this damn good. Cause baby, I feel real good and I wish I would. It's gotta be against the law to look this damn good. Everybody, watch out. Watch out now.